Okay, sorry for the interruption was there. Now we are going to read about the reversible change and irreversible change. The thing which is happening, or you can say the thing which is happening around us in our surrounding day to day life, minute to minute, second to second, these changes being happening around us is being classified into two groups. Which groups? Two groups. First is your reversible change, another one is your irreversible change. One thing also I should say, student, reversible changes are the physical changes. Reversible changes are the physical changes. Since the individual properties of the matter are still present, in reversible changes, the properties of the matters are still present. In your book, it has been also given a change which can be reversed to form the original substance is called reversible change. The change which can be reversed to form the original substance, that is called a reversible change. Now see, student, there are so many examples behind us and happening around us that I can't read one by one, but some of the example I can show you with the help of you and from the help of your book, that how this reversible change happens and what are the procedures and how the different states is being used in this reversible changes. Now this will become clear from the following example. Ice is a solid substance. Ice is a solid substance. As you all know, when you all freeze the water in the freezer, you get a very clear, bold, and in a solid state ice. When we heat ice, it melts to form liquid water. When the ice is given heat, or when the ice is kept at the room temperature also, you will see that it is being melted and it is in the form of a liquid. A change from solid to liquid takes place during the melting of ice. During the melting of ice. Now, if we cool the water from ice by keeping in the freezer of a refrigerator, it again changes into solid. Thus, the melting of ice to form water is a reversible change. You can see in this picture also reversible change. Ice heated water. Again, water is being freezed, we get ice. So, this is the very good example and very clear and a very understanding example for you all students, that when you all freeze the water, you get a ice. And when you take out that ice and keep it again in the at the room temperature only, on your dining table itself, you keep for half an hour, you will see that ice has been melted and it should be showing in a liquid form. Again, that liquid is again freezed. You will get the same ice as it was at the first. So, this is the example of reversible change. This is the example of reversible change. Some of the other examples of reversible changes are stretching of a rubber band, stretching of a rubber band or a spring, inflating a balloon, ironing of clothes, folding of paper, rolling a chapati from dough. Not cooking of chapati, rolling a chapati from dough. Again, we can do this. I will explain you. Dissolving salt or sugar in water, knitting of sweater. Again, woolen yarn to knitted sweater, the expansion or contraction of metals on heating and cooling respectively, etc. Now, I am going to give you some more examples which is being very clear to you at about the reversible changes. All the steam that is made when water in a kettle boils turn back into water by cooling it. Gas, see, steam is in the form of gas, and when this gas is cooled, we get the water. So there is only the state of matter has been changed, gas to liquid, but the reversible change will happen. How? Again, that cool water is being heated, it is again in the form of the steam. Another example. An electric bulb can be made to give light by passing electric current through it. An electric bulb can be made to give light by passing electric current through it. The bulb returns to its original state and does not give light when the electric current is switched off. See how you all are having bulb in your homes and the switches also. When you see a bulb, what you see? There is, it is giving the light. No, it is not giving the light. When you switch on, the light turns from the bulb. And again, when you switch off, the light disappears from the bulb. So this is the way, or you can say this is the original state from where bulb returns to its original state as it was at the first. It was not having light at the beginning, but when we switch on, it has the light. Again, when we switch off, there is no light. So this is also the reversible change. A blacksmith changes a piece of iron to different tools. For that, a piece of iron is heated to red hot. This is also softened. It is then beaten into the desired shape. It is a reversible change. When leaves of touch me not, plants is touched, they close and after some time open out again as they have not been done. As they have. Now see, the touch me not plant. Have you seen the touch me not plant? When you touch the touch me not plant, what it does? It closes all the leaves of it. And again, after some time, it opened out as it was before. So this is a reversible change. Now blacksmith. When blacksmith, what blacksmiths do? It gives the shape and size to different iron and make a different kinds of tool. How it do? If a piece of iron can make different tools by giving different shape and sizes, for this it has been heated iron to at a red hot. This red hot is being beaten into the desired shape. This is a reversible change. But how? If that shape has been given, again when that desired shape is heated to a red hot and leave it as it becomes to its same condition as it was a piece of iron. Now evaporation and condensation process are reverse of each other. Evaporation to the gas state and condensation gas to the water state. So it is also a reverse of each other. Evaporation changes in which a liquid gets converted into vapor, and condensation is the process in which vapor changes into a liquid when it is cooled. So these are the examples for your reversible changes. Now see, melting and boiling are also reversible processes. Melting and boiling. As melting, this changes in state occurs when a solid is heated to a particular temperature called the melting point. And in its state of matter changes from solid to liquid. Again, this brings about a change in state of liquid. A liquid when heated to a particular temperature called boiling point changes to vapor. Melting point and boiling point is also reversible to each other. How? Melting shows that solid is heated to a particular temperature, it comes to solid to liquid form. And in boiling, that liquid is given or heated to a particular temperature to change its state to liquid to gaseous or the vapor state. So this is the state of matter changes. Again, that vapor can be made into the solid state or in the liquid state. So this is also a reversible process. Our heartbeat increases on doing vigorous physical exercises. Nowadays you all are very free in your homes also, guardians are free. They must be doing different types of physical exercises early in morning to be keep themselves fit and fine. So when you and your guardian, your mother, father and parents are doing different kinds of exercises that time, physical exercises, what it becomes? It increases the heartbeat as it becomes normal after some time. Why? The heartbeat has a normal timing to beat. But when we do doing or when we do different types of exercise, that time our heartbeat increases. So this is also a reversible process. So many examples right now I had given you for the reversible processes. Now there is a thing I had seen here. Folding of paper, rolling a chapati from dough. Dough is the flour which your mother makes to prepare chapati. So that dough is again being made in chapati and that chapati is again being made as a dough. If chapati has not been rolled in a circle or it should be any cut over there, what your mother do? It again makes it as a dough because it has not been till yet cooked. If it is being cooked, then it can't be reversed into a dough. This is the irreversible process. So rolling of chapati from dough is a reversible. But if this chapati has been cooked, then it can't be reversed into the dough. So this is irreversible changes. Rolling of chapati comes in both the processes, reversible and irreversible. So this was the end of the video of reversible changes. I will be back again with your irreversible changes and with their examples and explanation. For this time, student, hear the video once, twice and thrice. Do the assignment, read the notes clearly and have a nice day.